From the windy city of Chicago, baseball from beautiful Wrigley Field. Today, it's an American League Central Division matchup between the Minnesota Twins and the Cleveland Indians. Indians baseball is next. Ready now is Luis Arraez, and we are ready for some daytime baseball. Into the windup, here's the 2-1 pitch. A very fine afternoon for baseball, 67 degrees here at first pitch. Fastball didn't miss by much, and it's a full count now, 3-2.
Well, you don't see it all that often, but this might be a good time for a 3-2 change. If he can locate it, it's nearly impossible to hit.
Ramirez comes in a few steps as he hauls it in for the first out. So bases are empty with one gone, and that'll bring up the speedy outfielder Byron Buxton. The 1-1 home. It's taken for strike two.
Not likely to see a fourth fastball in this situation. I'm going to eliminate the fastball if I'm at the plate right here.
Looked like the fastball got away from him there. It's ball two.
That's a good take on a fastball out of the zone. Hey, I get it. He's looking for a ball to drive, but that ball was a little bit too far up in the zone. That's one you normally pop right up.
And he will make the play out there, and there are two away now. Next, it'll be Jorge Polanco. Lifetime against this pitcher. Comes in with six hits in 24 at-bats. Counts even, 2-2 for Polanco. Fouled away.
I know that's the spot he didn't want to miss in, but he got away with it.
Got him swinging, and that will end the inning. Now to the plate, here is Miles Straw. He'll lead things off here in the bottom half of the first. Two and one now to the Tribe's leadoff man. Line drive, and that's a base hit into center field. And just one batter in, the Twins will have to handle a threat on the base pass. Stepping in now, Ahmed Rosario. Indian shortstop behind one and two in the count. Use the slide step.
Yeah, he's clearly thinking about the steal right here. Didn't happen, but the cat and mouse game continues on.
Hit in the air out to right. Kepler's on the move. He gets there to make the play for the first out of the inning. Now into the box. Jose Ramirez head to head against Michael Pineda. He's hitting 429.
Ramirez.
Throw over to the bag. Just manages to get his hand in. The 2-1 home. Outside, quite a bit off the plate that time.
Defense has got to be on their toes right here. 3-2 count, runner on first has got some serious wheels. You know he's probably being put in motion.
And that'll get down out there near the wall. Strong rounds the corner and is headed home. And he's safe at the plate as they take the lead.
That is good. Look, everything is hitting.
Into the box now, Fran Morales. Count moves to a ball and two strikes now. This is foul right side. Pineda pauses, looking to put him away here on a ball and two strikes. And a wave and a miss on a ball that was way out of the strike zone. There are two away now.
set. The payoff pitch.
And a fastball swung on and hit to second. He's got it. Throw on to first gets him, and the side is retired. So now to the plate, Josh Donaldson. In his career versus this pitcher, he's a 375 hitter. Two of those hits were for home runs. That nibbled the corner there, but missed. 2-1. Late swing there on the changeup. Couldn't make up his mind, I guess. It's strike two.
Hey, I'd like to see a little bit more discipline than that. You get a count in your favor. He's swinging a pitch that bad. Not good.
Full count, three balls and two strikes to the Twins DH. Good battle. Count remains full. And another foul ball. Into the windup, ready with the payoff pitch. Sliced hard on the ground. And that is through into right field for a single.
That is it. The right fielder, Matt.
And now Max Kepler. He's fallen behind now, 3-1. And that misses for ball four. And it's first and second now with nobody out.
That is good.
Now with the plate, Miguel Sano trying here to plate the tying run from second. The 1-1 misses for the second ball.
Hey, time to start making some quality pitches. He finds himself in a tough spot behind an account with guys on base.
And it's fouled away. Donaldson on second. Kepler on at first with nobody out. To third. Ramirez is up with it. The second for one. On to first, and they get the double play. Ryan Jeffers will have to get loose in a hurry now as he'll come in and run following the injury. Striding in is Nick Gordon, a potential tying run for him at third base. Two outs here with a runner at third. Three and two now. Payoff pitch on its way. High and deep down the left field line. But this will wind up being a foul ball. He set the 3-2. High pop up. Rosario is there. And he makes the catch to retire the side. Last half of the second set to go. And next to bat will be the outfielder, Harold Ramirez. Here he comes on a ball and two strikes. Weak roller right side. Knee high, he barehands it. Hey now. In now for Cleveland, Bradley Zimmer.
The right fielder, Bradley Zimmer.
Left side, but well fouled. Bases are empty, one man out. Lifted down the line in left. But this is going to wind up a foul ball.
Another full count pitch home. To third, and there are two away. Now at the plate here is Roberto Perez. Into the windup, here's the 2-1 pitch. Too much bite on the breaking ball that time as it's well off the outside.
This is a good at bat so far here with two away. If you're going to go down 1-2-3, at least make the guy work for it. He's doing that, and he's even gotten himself into a good hitter's count now.
A swing and a high drive to right center field. Into the bleachers and gone. So now to the plate, Andrés Giménez. And he lays off this one down and in for ball two.
Boy, that's one of the toughest pitches to lay off. A hard breaking ball at the back foot. Tough take on a terrific pitch.
Kepler gets under it and makes the catch to end the inning. So now into the box is Mitch Garver. We are all set to begin the third inning in this one.
You know, these next couple innings are really important for these guys. I know they're only down by a couple, but they need to get something going on offense to keep pace, even though it's early. The offense better get it going right here, because they certainly can tell from their dugout. This guy is carrying himself with a presence out on the mound. He's got feel for all his pitches.
A swing and a drive sent out toward the gap. Strong is back near the ivy as he makes the catch for the first down. The next twin up, Andrelton Simmons. Lifetime in this matchup. He's a 333 hitter. Count remains full. Turned on, but that's ripped foul down the third baseline. And he finally wins the battle as this is swung on and missed for the second out. That'll bring up Luis Arraez. Flew out in his only at bat so far. 3-1.
A 3-1 count, tying run on deck. Good spot to be a hitter right now. You have to look for something middle in.
And this misses for ball four. The second walk he surrendered here in the first three innings.
Hey, usually the second time through the order, you start seeing an incorporation of some more off-speed stuff. But this guy's locating and feeling really
good. We'll leave it right there as he strikes out, and that ends the inning. So now here is Miles Straw as we move on to the bottom of inning number three. The 1-1. Looked at for ball number two. Fastball is looked at for strike two. The 2-2. Down the left field line and deep. And foul. Into the windup. Here comes the 2-2 pitch. Hit out towards second. Fielded cleanly, and there's one down now. Into the box, Ahmed Rosario flied out in his first at bat, so making 0-for-1 so far. Pineda into his motion, 2-2 on its way home. Off-speed pitch, and there is strike three called, and boy, that zone just got a bit larger. Two away. Bases are empty here with two men out. And he takes ball three, so it's a full count now. And he turns this one around high and deep to center field. A ball that's carrying. And he makes a nice catch on the track as that ends the inning. New inning set to get underway, and that'll bring in Jorge Polanco to hit next. And he'll lay off the curveball that's in the dirt that time, and it's back to even now at 2-2. Hard hit ball to second. Oh, what a play! He's out! And that's a huge play to keep the leadoff man off base.
The battle. The designated hitter, Ryan Jeffers.
Next to hit, Ryan Jeffers. The 1-1. Strike two swinging.
1-10.
This pitcher's bringing it with some high velo. You better get that front foot down early and get ready, or he's going to throw it right by you.
Oh. Didn't miss by much there, but it's just a bit high.
We just saw a fastball right there. I would not be shocked if he tries to get this guy to go fishing right here and drops a little off-speed pitch in the dirt.
Now another 2-2.
That's the ball. Three balls.
And that is swung on and missed. He's down on strikes, and the first two are retired here to begin inning number four. So two gone now for the Twins in their half of the fourth, and that'll bring up the outfielder Max Kepler. Full count to Max Kepler, three balls and two strikes. Miguel Sano would be next. Swung on and missed, and that's the final out of the inning. Ready to go in the bottom of the fourth, and striding forward, the designated hitter, Franmil Reyes. The 1-1. Fastball called, strike three, and there's the first out of the inning. Digging in next, Bobby Bradley. Pineda into his motion. Here's a 1-1. Not close with the off-speed pitch taken for a ball. And it's two balls and two strikes now. One out, nobody on. Had to wait back on the changeup, and he did a good job just to make contact. And he's getting his money's worth up there now. It's full 3-2. And now a slider in there for a called third strike. And there are two gone now.
The left fielder, number 10.
So next to bat will be Harold Ramirez. Two outs already on the K this inning, so he'll be looking to do better. Fly ball out to straightaway right field. And no trouble for him as he makes the catch to end the inning. All set for the start of the inning, and set to go is the veteran first baseman Miguel Sano. And he fouls this one off. Here comes the 1-2.
Nope. 2-2. Yep.
High and deep to left center field. Back on it is the left fielder. Gone to lead off the inning. At the plate now, Nick Gordon. Swing and a miss. Good sinking action there. 1-2. Fastball is right by him as he swings and misses for the first out of the inning. So next to hit is Mitch Garver. He flew out in his last AB.
Almost, Matty. Almost went deep his last AB. Certainly just missed it. With this guy's big power, he's feeling pretty good at the dish. Look for him to try and get on something and drive it out of the yard this AB.
Trying to nibble here, and he misses to run it full now. 3-2. And that misses for ball four. In now is Andrelton Simmons. One in, one out, and one on here in the inning. Good job to spoil that one away, and he stays alive. Garver stands at first with one out. Hit in the air out to straightaway left.
Ramirez
is there to put it away, and the runner will be forced to retreat back to first. So two are gone in the Twins' half of the fifth. And next to hit will be Luis Arraez. Two and one now to the Twins' leadoff man. There's a swing and a high drive into left center field. Going back is the left fielder. And they take the lead. It's gone. To the plate now, Byron Buxton. Changed things up on him, and he got him to swing through it. One and two now. And the slider runs away from him there, and the count levels at two and two.
Now for four innings, he was great. But here in the fifth, he looks like a completely different guy out there. That happens a lot when a pitcher is facing batters for the second or third time in a game.
Too close for comfort, and he did a good job just to make contact.
Well, somebody's sitting off speed right here. Only way he was late on that heater is he was expecting another changeup.
Strong is underneath this one, and he will put it away to retire the side. And that'll bring in the San Diego product, Bradley Zimmer. Hit it hard but lined out in his first at bat.
Yeah, Matty, it's always a little frustrating when you square one up. You hit a solid line drive like he did, and all you have to show for it is a jog back to the dugout. That can get in your head for a little while.
Throw will not be in time as a perfect bunt there nets him a base runner to lead off the inning. Stepping in now, Roberto Perez. Still showing bunt with two strikes, but he pulls it back. Three and two.
Yeah, now you've got a guy up there trying to give you an out by bunting. So the last thing you want to do is waste. Maybe put yourself in a situation where you could walk him.
The throw pulls him off the bag. Andres Jimenez the next to bat. Base knock to the outfield could score the tying run from second. Two and two. Rounded down the third baseline. Reined in. There's one on the first, but not in time as he's in there ahead of the throw. And now here is Miles Straw trying to bring in the tying run from third here. Can't keep the weight back, and he falls behind one and two. Pineda pauses. Here it is. Fifth inning of play here in a 3-2 ball game. Hit the other way out toward right field. Kepler's there for it. Makes the catch, but the runner from third breaks for home. And he will score on the sacrifice fly as that ties our ball game at 3-3. So we're back to even now after the sack fly. And stepping up is the shortstop, Ahmed Rosario. The 1-1 pitch.
Hey, after those two breaking balls missed, you have to be sitting on a fastball right here.
Fastball catches the black there for a called strike.
Hey, I still believe in my heart the best pitch is a well-executed fastball down and away, and that's exactly what that is. He swings at that. That's off the bat. That's not hard contact at all, and that's an easy out for the defense.
No walks yet. Here's the delivery. Lined hard to center field, and that's in there. Base hit. So now they'll have two men in scoring position following the two-out double.
Now batting,
Standing in now, Jose Ramirez. A ball and two strikes now. Pulled toward right center field. Kepler is under it, and he makes the catch for out number three. Kristen McKenzie takes over to start the sixth inning on the mound.
Number 24.
Top half of the sixth about to get started, and that'll bring in Jorge Polanco to hit next. The 1-1 home. Takes a pass and misses. That's strike two.
Yeah, guys, he's got so much respect for this guy's fastball. You could tell he was out in front on that slider. I think he goes to the well one more time with that pitch.
The count now at 2-2.
Lucky he got a piece right there. He was definitely late on that pitch after seeing a previous off-speed pitch.
Just out in front of that one, still 2-2. Here it comes.
Hey, last two pitches back to back, off speed, then he's late on the fastball. He could pretty much do anything he wants right here on the mound.
Did well just to make contact there as he spoils off a good changeup. Fouled off. Off-speed pitch in the dirt as he takes it for a ball.
After multiple pitches were fouled off, it gets a little disappointing as a pitcher. So you think, say, I'm going to throw one way off the plate and see if he'll chase it. Didn't happen.
Now Ryan Jeffers.
Into the box now, Ryan Jeffers. In for a strike, and he jumps ahead 1-2 now. And this is taken for a ball high and tight. 2-2.
2-2.
One thing to take note of is how these last two batters have really driven up his pitch count. He's had to use 14 pitches already on them, and he's not even through this guy yet. 14 is near the top end of what you want to throw in a complete inning.
Got him to miss the breaking ball there. Ryan Jeffers goes down to become the first out in the sixth inning. There's a fastball well off the plate for a ball. Fouled away. Here now the 2-2. And there goes Polanco. Swing and a miss, strike three. The throw. And he'll be tagged out at second base. Trying to get into scoring position, but instead the inning is over. Ralph Garza enters to do the pitching in the bottom of the sixth.
Number 32.
And that'll bring in Franmil Reyes. He'll get the sixth inning started for Cleveland. And he'll try to get him fishing there, but he won't offer in dirt, and it's back to even at 2-2. Weak grounder down the line at third. But a foul ball as it holds at 2-2. Into the windup and the pitch. Hot shot down the line. But this is going to be a foul ball as that keeps things at 2-2. Full count, 3-2 to the Indians DH.
You can certainly tell at bats like this one frustrate the heck out of a pitcher. But you got to find a way to stay composed and execute your plan.
Throw to first is in time for the first out. Next up is Bobby Bradley. He's hitless in his two at-bats so far. Three runs, five hits. No errors to this point for the Indians. Oh, a fastball swung on and missed. And for the second time today, he's gone on strikes. Stepping up is Harold Ramirez. It was a flyout for him in his last trip. Here's a fastball, not close, as he runs it to 2-1 now. He has fallen behind now, 3-1.
3-1.
Hitters count all the way. Here it comes. Skied in the air to straightaway left. Gordon will get there, and he puts it away to retire the side. Seventh inning ready to roll, and next will be the imposing power bat, Miguel Sano.
Yeah, Matt, and going back to that last at bat when he hit the homer, that was a fastball that was up in the zone. This guy likes the ball up in the zone, so if I'm on the mound right now, I'm thinking try to keep the ball at the knees and below. He doesn't handle that low pitch quite as well.
That's off the end of the bat, foul, and he might have been fortunate to stay alive that time. And he takes strike three called on the fastball. One gone. One gone now in the Minnesota seventh. And that'll bring in the speedy Nick Gordon. From the windup, the 1-1 pitch. And they'll run this one in on him, and he can't connect, so he finds himself down 1-2 now.
Not much he can do with that one. Tied him up in knots.
Swung on, but fouled off to the left. Three runs, four hits, and one error make up the totals for the Twins to this point. Still 1-2. Another one sent foul. Again, a 1-2. Slider laid off for a ball.
The classic back foot slider right there with two strikes. Usually gets a ton of swing and misses. Nice layoff right there. Fight for another pitch.
3-2 pitch. Now a ball hit sharply toward third. That gets down. He's got himself a base hit. He's through first and hustling for second. And he'll reach second now with one away. So now to the plate, Mitch Garver. And that misses ball four. So with one out, that'll at least set up the double play possibility here that could get them out of the inning. Gordon at second. Garver is over at first with one away. And a check swing here as he couldn't help himself, and it's ruled strike two. Inside and a hair low. It's two balls and two strikes. And there's ball three on a breaking ball that misses away.
For the guy on the mound, this is one of those innings where nothing comes easy. He's thrown a bunch of pitches, and this AB hasn't been any different. Definitely laboring at the moment.
And he will make the catch back there as they're a step closer to getting out of this with two away now. Now back to the top of the lineup. Stepping in, Luis Arraez. Two outs and two runners aboard here in the seventh inning. Well outside with the curveball for a ball.
He's got a couple of pitches to deal with right here, but he's starting to lose command of his pitches. It might be time to take a step back and try to refocus and make him some good pitches.
2-2. Here it is. Hit hard toward the right side. And that is down for extra bases as that ought to plate the go-ahead run and maybe another. As he arrives at second without a play, as a run is also in, and with it, they take the lead. Blake Parker will slide in now and try to work out of this. Runners in second and third with two gone. At the plate now, Byron Buxton. Now a good pitch around the knees, but it doesn't quite catch the bottom of the zone. Two and one, here it is.
Four-seam heater right down the middle. I would have thought he popped the clutch on that pitch.
He got him. And exhale as he's out of the jam and the inning is over. And now in the box, Bradley Zimmer, a hit and two tries for him so far. Tries to drag his way on here, but now he's behind 1-2. Still a ball and two strikes. Another 1-2 delivery.
Put that in the memory bank. First time he breaks out a curveball right there, and it's a pretty good one.
Hit back up the middle. And that's through into center field. So the tying runs aboard to kick off the inning.
The catcher, number 55. Roberto.
In now, Roberto Perez. And the play for the tie here as he puts this one down. Simmons, but they won't get two as he beats the relay to first. So with a left-handed hitter waiting, they'll go to their own left-hander out of the bullpen. Andres Jimenez will be the first to greet him here as he'll stand in with a runner at first and one away. One and one, here it comes.
Looked like he was a little over-aggressive there to throw that nasty curveball. Just needs to slow his delivery down a bit.
Oh, not an easy pitch to lay off of, but he did somehow, and he's got it to 3-1.
Well, this is the matchup they wanted, bringing in the reliever, but falling behind 2-0 doesn't exactly help the situation very much.
Down the third baseline. And it's fouled away. The next 3-2. Now a swing and a softly hit ground ball. And he missed with it. Ball four. So that means now the potential tying run will move into scoring position at second. Now at the plate is Miles Straw. It was an RBI sac fly for him last time through. In the dirt here. Goes to third with it. And oh, they say he beat the throw. Safe at third. So now 2 men in scoring position. Two pitches fouled away. Three and two to the Indian center fielder.
That's a good pitch to lay off right there, that cutter inside. And that is a real tough pitch for hitters to lay off of. And a lot of times, if you do swing at that cutter in, you're going to end up with some firewood and a broken bat.
Now it'll be Ahmed Rosario, singled in his last at bat. Big spot, two out, possible tying and go-ahead runs on base. And a pitch down that swung on and sent to second base. On to first, and the Tribe are held in check as the inning is over. Digging in, the switch hitter, Jorge Polanco, singled last time up. The 1-1. Hit hard on the ground is short. Rosario brings it in. Throw on to first in time, so the leadoff man is set down to open up inning number 8. Now the number 4 Minnesota hitter, Ryan Jeffers, 0-for-2 for him to this point. Just behind the fastball there. Two strikes now. Now a fastball awfully close, but he doesn't get the call. It's 2-2 now. And he struck out again. That's the third time he's gone down on strikes in this one. Max Kepler the next to grab a bat. He was sat down on strikes in his last at-bat.
Yeah, and kind of shocked he got blown away with a fastball. You could tell he was late on that one. And we'll see if he tries to cheat to something this AB.
3-1. was a called strike at the knees as he was hoping for a base on balls there, but it's a full count now, 3-2. Now the payoff pitch home. Both teams with six hits so far. Down the left field line and deep. And foul. Good swing just a little early, and he'll see another payoff pitch. The 3-2 one more time.
Hey, have an AB right here. I know it's frustrating the heck out of the pitcher. You keep fouling these pitches off, maybe one misses over the heart of the plate.
Another payoff pitch. And he fouls this one off.
Hey, five foul balls in a row. Loving the battle in the box right here, making the pitcher work.
Pulled toward right center field. Center fielder on the run. He gets there to make the play, and that ends the inning. Tyler Duffy is on to pitch out of the bullpen in the bottom half of the eighth.
Number 21. Tyler.
Jose Ramirez will be the first one to greet him here as he'll be forced to turn around and hit from the left side now. 1-1. Seared down the first baseline, and he'll take it to the bag himself. Next will be the cleanup hitter, Fran Moreno. The numbers against Tyler Duffy, he's 0-4. Into the windup. Here's the 2-1 pitch. Fouled off. 2-2. Swung on and missed, strike three. So stepping in is Bobby Bradley, 0-3 with a couple of strikeouts for him to this point in the ballgame. Set to deliver on 2-1. And a half swing here, but this is in there for a called strike two. This is hit the other way out toward left field. And eight innings have come and gone now as the inning is over. Trevor Stephan enters from the pen to start the ninth inning as he'll try to keep the score right where it is heading to the bottom of the ninth. Here's Miguel Sano. He's working on a 1-for-3 thus far. Now a pitch hit sharply on the ground, but this will get foul, so they'll do it again. 3-2. The payoff pitch one more time. Swung on and missed. He got him on strikes. At the plate now is Nick Gordon. He doubled his last time up.
And he's got to build off that last AB. He battled. Usually when you battle, you get in that swing mode. A lot of pitches, you'll swing at the rosin bag. I love the fact that he was able to work a double in last at bat. Let's see if we get more of the same right here.
That's popped up. Rosario waits on it, makes the play, and there are two gone now. Next, here is Mitch Garver. It was a walk in his last trip. Grounded to third. Ramirez is there. Throw in time, and the side is retired. Alex Colomé comes out of the bullpen to shut things down here in the ninth.
Number 48.
All set for the bottom of the ninth. And that'll bring up the outfielder, Harold Ramirez. Here it comes. Lofted in the air out toward right center. Kepler's there for it. And that's the first out of the inning. Up next, Bradley Zimmer. He's 2-for-3 thus far.
Zimmer.
swing and a ground ball to third. But this will get foul. It's a ball and two strikes. A great pitch there as he couldn't get extended on that one, and he's down on strikes for the second out.
The catcher, number 55.
Now to bat, Roberto Perez. Perhaps he can drive another one out of the park, just like he did back in the second. And that's taken for strike two, as now they're down to their final strike here this afternoon. Able to protect the plate with two strikes, and he'll see another one. Last strike now for Cleveland. Now a swing and a fly ball. And this should do it. Kepler's there for it. Makes the catch, and that's the ball game.
Hey, this was a pretty tightly played game. Got a little bit of everything in this one. Some timely hitting, runs on the board, key pitching, and defense in certain spots. This one was a fun one to watch.
A one-run finish, 4-3, the final tally today. The Minnesota Twins jumped ahead in the seventh inning and never gave the lead back. Ralph Garza pitches well enough to get the W. So that'll do it for us. For Mark DeRosa, Dan Plezak, Heidi Watney, and our entire crew, I'm Matt Vaskirjan. You've been watching MLB The Show. For more, make your way over to the new website, theshow.com.
The final line score for this afternoon's ball game: for the victorious Twins, 4 runs on 6 hits, 1 error, they left 5 men on base. For Cleveland, 3 runs.